Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to Prince Midler Entertainment TV, the channel. Follow us on all our social media platforms, Instagram and Facebook, Prince Midler Entertainment, Prince Midler Entertainment, and also available on our Facebook group, which is Prince Midler Entertainment TV, and also on our Twitter handle, at PMidlerENT. Welcome to another edition of our daily news on breaking news. Today is the 13th of April, 2021. So guys, yesterday I did report it saying that there's one Zimbabwean who passed away, you know, in Palma and Mozambique, and his name was Nyasha Mukwagwa, you know, may he so rest in peace. So another Zimbabwean who was there, and Pashakaitika, you know, it's very scary. So I'm just gonna read, you know, what he said regarding to the whole situation in Palma. And so Zimbabwean national Brian Majumbo, who survived the 24 March attack on Palma, Mozambique, says he spent 2 days in the bush after his vehicle was ambushed while working for Kia Projects. Majumbo's vehicle was found abandoned with a body next to it, and the colleagues feared he was dead. Speaking to Zim Live from Manica after he finally been rescued on April 4, Majumbo said he saw at least 200 bodies and at least 50 with heads severed. His account could not be verified. The Mozambique government, eager to be in Palma, has so far not said how many people died. Majumbo, originally from Murewa, said many Zimbabweans working on the gas projects had changed their names by acquiring fake Mozambican identity documents. His was Ibrahim. He said there was Max, a mechanic. They beheaded him for being a Rasta. From Kia, where I worked, two people I'm still missing. One of them is Tennyson, but I'm sure that's not his real name. Then there are two Zimbabwean sisters I know from church, Monica and Mariana from CMSG Catering. They can be found. I also know brothers Tony and Alan who are still missing. Most of those that died could not or did not run for it. They thought the accommodation that their companies were renting was safe, but the insurgents breached the security and searched every room. Meanwhile, the family of Nyasha Mukwagwa, another Zimbabwean who went missing following the attack, said the 38-year-old is dead. Shutting down a missing person appeal on social media Monday, the family said it had been established that Nyasha, who was a catering manager for remote site solutions at the multi-billion dollar gas projects being built by Francis Atoto, the other energy companies, died on March 28, said the family. And yeah, so Amana Pagaipa. And it's so sad, you know, that's one of those a risk that you are taking when you go to a foreign country. In the Nama Pepa Kakwana, most of us, of course, my Zimbabweans, we end up talking some star city because Tinta Shansama documents in Momo and got a fake and my saga. Those are not someone Pagatica, my problems are die so because no one knows your real name. A pan was out, it's around the prince. Dina Jones, Isaac. Isaac is something. It's one of those situations that you know, always affects us as Zimbos. Kuti kana nyaya yasvika pakadai so inenge yakutonetsa kuti uziva kuti angari muZimbabwe here kana kuti angari muMozambique, and you can't even know because hana madocuments acho anoratidza kuti ndekupi, unless patoonekwa kunzi angane passport yekuZimbabwe or whatsoever. But as far as I'm concerned, it's so difficult to know kuti maZimbabwe asiri kuwanikwa ikoko kuMozambique mangani, because most of these guys were using fake documents. And so guys, I will send condolences messages to Mukwagwa's family and all other, you know, families who have lost their loved ones on that oil region of Palma and in Cabo Delgado, Mozambique. And we send condolences messages, and it's one of those situations that it was supposed to be prevented. And my Mozambican, they knew kuti this whole insurgents need to be flushed as soon as possible, but they wakalenga lenga. That's why these guys end up, you know, attacking on that day on the 24th March 2021. It's so scary. At the same time, it's so unbelievable kuti zvakadai so zvinowasa kuitika just on our neighboring country Mozambique. So guys, let's talk in the comment section, and remember guys to follow us on all our social media platform. I'll keep you guys up to date with the latest trick this whole issue. My incidents are actually, although Sadiq Yara to Miravan, you know, I'll keep you up to date with the Ramira say, but as far as I'm concerned, I just wish we could die on where vessels or our flash were out. They need to be flushed out. At the same time, they don't need to be arrested. Ngawa flash out because they killed a lot of people. They've killed a lot of people, and so many if end up seeking refugees kune dzimwe dzvimbo. Ngavasiya zvipfuyo zvavo, vasiya dzimba dzavo, vasiya zvinhu zvakawanda. You know, so these people, they don't deserve to be arrested. They deserve to die. Kill on spot. And we don't go to because they've actually done a horrible job there in Mozambique. Guys, let's talk. This is a daily news on breaking news on Prince Mila Entertainment TV. It's a very, very sad situation. I could imagine with my family's how are they going through this whole massacre in Mozambique. And I'm a one church. Daily news on breaking news on Prince Mila Entertainment TV. Thank you very much for listening and watching. And remember, guys, to turn on the notification bell not to miss any of our new uploads we upload each and every day. Bless up.